Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the in-data project at Easterseals Crossroads, and today we're going to be talking about the Windows built-in on-screen keyboard. So let's go ahead and take a look.
All right, so today we're going to take a look at the on-screen keyboard that's built into Windows. This has been there for a little while, and maybe some folks know about it. I'm sure a lot of folks don't know about it, but there's been a built-in keyboard, and it does a few different things for folks who may have issues with traditional access to kind of the keyboard that plugs into your computer, the physical keyboard that connects to your computer. So for folks who have difficulty using kind of a standard keyboard, this might be a helpful tool for you. The first thing we're going to do is come out here to our kind of put in here, and we're going to bring up the control panel. So you can just type that into your Windows area. You'll open it up. Essentially what's interesting about this is when you get to the control panel, your control panel might look like this. And so it might be set up with categories and other things. I always tell folks, go ahead and just list small icons if you can see them, because it's going to show you all the different features. Things aren't going to be hidden from you. And then over here on the left, and depending on the size of the window, it might move around a little bit, but you're going to find something called Ease of Access Center. You can click on the Ease of Access Center. When you open up that, there's a ton of different really useful, helpful accessibility tools that are built into Windows. And one of those, again, is the on-screen keyboard, which we want to talk about today. In the top of the Ease of Access Center, you're going to see this little thing called Start the On-Screen Keyboard. So we're going to go ahead and do that. And then instantly, you're going to see a little keyboard, kind of a white text on a black background kind of keyboard pop up. And I'm going to go ahead and open up a Word document. So I'll pop that up behind. Notice that the keyboard stays on top of anything and everything. So it's there. I'll bring that document back up again. You can make it bigger, you can make it smaller, you can really do it, make it just any size you really want. The challenge you will find is just trying to make sure it doesn't cover up what you're trying to see or type into. Now, the first option, there are really three ways to use this keyboard. There is the click feature. In fact, I'll open up our options menu and we'll let you see that. There's this called click on keys, there's this hover over keys, and then there's this scan through keys. You can turn on text prediction, and if you did have that turned on, you can actually insert spaces after the predicted words. I always encourage folks to just leave text prediction on, because if the word pops up there, you can just choose the word instead of having to continue to type it out. Just makes things a little bit faster. And you can also add a numeric keyboard to it as well, to your keyboard as well, once it's on there, to be able to include that if 10 key is something that you do a lot with numbers and other kinds of things. What we're going to do is we're going to leave it on click on keys. I'll say, okay, I'm in my document and I'm just going to type hello. And so I'm going to just hit shift. And this is again, click on keys. I'm just clicking on the keys with my mouse. And so you can see I'm just clicking on them. It's going ahead and doing that. I'm going to change it to the second option, which is hover on keys or hover over keys. And right now you'll notice I've got a 1.5 second delay. This means that I don't have to click a button. I just have to hover over a letter or a number or a symbol for 1.5 seconds. And then it's going to automatically fill it in. And the cool thing is it visually shows you on the key that you're hovering over, which one it's going to press. And so just to show you this, I'll click OK. We'll type the same thing. Notice the visual representation there, that it's going to click that key. You can also adjust that speed to whatever typing speed the person that you're working with might need or that you might need. The one thing that is needed with either click on keys and or hover over keys is you need to be able to move the mouse around the keyboard. And if you were, just to show you this word, I'll just pick a word up here. You can choose words off there as well. And then if I move my mouse off the keyboard, it stops and I can kind of readjust and see what I've written, make sure it's correct. and basically move around with the keyboard to make corrections or other kinds of things that I need. Probably the more sophisticated option behind this is I'm going to go ahead and hit open options again. I'm going to go ahead and turn on scan through keys. So I'll click that. It's going to still have a second and a half delay. This opens up an option for folks who need scanning. So if you can press a button or you're able to connect a switch up to your computer. So let's say you can blink your eye or wiggle your big toe or move your head side to side or really a variety of different things. You can use scan through keys. And I'll give you an example of what that looks like. And I'm going to use my mouse button to be able to activate my switch. You can use the mouse click. You can use your space bar. You can use a mouse click. You can also hook up a switch to your computer to make this work for you too. So, but I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And I'm going to go and say I need to hit the enter key twice. And so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to click my mouse button. Click my mouse button again when I got to the row that I want. Now that I'm near the enter key. Let that scan through. Sorry, I had my mouse outside of the keyboard, which caused a little bit of confusion for it. Go down here. And it clicked on that enter key. So I'm just, it starts out with big sections. Which is a row at a time. And if I get to the row that I want to hit my enter key one more time. So I'm going to let it go rotate through again. Get to that row that has the enter key, click. Once it gets over to the section that has the enter key, I'm going to click again, click. Once it gets to the key itself, click. It's going to go ahead and put that in there for me. You can see this is a little bit more challenging. Even this last one, I put the apostrophe in instead of the enter key. So I missed the one that I wanted, but still kind of a useful tool. If you get used to it, you can set it up to either move faster or slower on whatever your click speed is, to be able to then type on the keyboard, type and use the computer with the built-in on-screen keyboard through Windows. And again, it's got a lot of different settings. I see a lot of folks use different options as far as how they want to operate it, whether that's click on keys, hover over keys, or scan through keys. But all the same, they're super helpful and useful. And so hopefully this is something new to you. And if it's something that you can use, hopefully that'll work. Thanks so much.
Well, that's your tech tip for today. I want to say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads in Indiana.